In this lecture, we will learn how to build arguments using rules of inference. Let's consider the premises. Randy works hard. If Randy works hard, then he is a dull boy. And if Randy is a dull boy, then he will not get the job. These are the set of premises. And we need to conclude that Randy will not get the job from these set of premises. That is our job. Okay. Now let's say, let H is Randy works hard, D is Randy is a dull boy, and J is Randy will get the job. Now what we need to do, we first need to convert these premises in propositional variable form. That is, Randy works hard can be rewritten as H. If Randy works hard, then he is a dull boy can be rewritten as H implies D. And if Randy is a dull boy, then he will not get the job can be rewritten as D implies not J. Right? And finally, we can say our conclusion would be therefore not J. Right? Because Randy will not get the job can be rewritten as not J. As J is, Randy will get the job. Therefore, not J is, Randy will not get the job. Okay. Now we can easily see that this argument is not in the form of any of the rule of inference that we studied in the previous lecture, right? Because here we are having three premises and one conclusion. And we already know that whatever the rules of inference we already learned, there are two premises in almost all of them and one conclusion. And there are some of them which are having only one premise and one conclusion. So what we can do with this argument? How do we able to come to this conclusion by using rules of inference? What we need to do is, we need to take two premises at the time, any two premises we can choose. And what we need to do is, we need to come up with some conclusion by using rule of inference. Okay? Like for example, we can take H and H implies D. H and H implies D. Now we can apply the rule of modus ponens here and we can come to this conclusion called D. Right? Here we applied rule of modus ponens. Okay? So conclusion D can be obtained from these two premises very easily by using rule of modus ponens. And the next step would be to take another two premises and try to come up with another conclusion. We can take D and D implies not J. D implies not J. Please note down that it is not necessary that you would always have to take two premises from this place only. It is also possible that you can take conclusion of one argument as a premise to the other argument. Like in this case, we chose D, which is the conclusion of this argument, as a premise of this particular argument. As here also, in case of D and D implies not J, we can again apply rule of modus ponens to come to this conclusion called not J, by again using the rules of modus ponens. Not J is our desired conclusion, right? That is what we want. So we can say that by using rules of inference, we can build this argument and finally we come to our desired conclusion, that is not J. And this is what we have to learn. Now it is also not necessary to take two premises at a time. In the worst case, you may take one premise also and you can apply either simplification rule or you can apply addition rule, right? But please remember, try to take two premises at a time and try to come up with some conclusion and go step by step then. It is also possible that the conclusion that you get from one argument is of no use for the other argument. So it is not always the case that whatever the conclusion you are getting from one argument can be used as a premise for the other argument. And it may also be the case that conclusion of one argument can be chosen as a premise for the other argument. So there is a total freedom in selection of premises, but your ultimate goal is to obtain the final conclusion. Okay? Let's now take H implies D and D implies not J. H implies D, D implies not J. Okay, H implies D and D implies not J. From these two premises, we can conclude H implies not J by using hypothetical syllogism, right? By the rule of hypothetical syllogism, when there is a premise P implies Q and Q implies R, then we can get P implies R as our conclusion. Now, we can take this premise H and from these two premises, we can get the conclusion not J, which is our final desired conclusion, right? This is obtained by using rule of modus ponens. As you can clearly see in this example, I chose H and H implies D initially, and here in this example, I chose H implies D and D implies not J. So it totally depends on you what premises you choose, but finally we should get our desired conclusion, that is in this case, not J, right? Okay friends, this is it for now. Thank you for watching this lecture.